My guest for the English edition of Radio Irava is Mr. Shahram Golestaneh, head of Iran Democratic Association. Shahram is in Toronto and he's going to tell us about the gathering in Toronto that has angered not only the Iranian Canadians, but Canadian federal and provincial politics. Good afternoon, Shahram. Could you tell us what is going on in Toronto today and are you at the scene right now?
Good afternoon and thank you for having me on the show. I'm actually now in front of the so-called Islamic Society of the York region, mm-hmm. where supposed to be a commemoration of Khomeini, with luring actually young people and teenagers for the cause of Khomeini, which is no different than the cause of Islamic State or ISIS.
Are they to support the gathering or they're opposing the gathering?
No, of course, the people who are in front of the center, there are hundreds of Iranians, and not only Iranians, there are many other people as well, Canadians from other origins, but mostly Canadian of Iranian origin, Iranian Canadians, mm-hmm. who have gathered here to protest and actually to raise their voice that commemorating Khomeini is incitement to crime for someone who has been officially condemned in the Canadian Parliament as being the master of crime against humanity for his order of execution of thousands of political prisoners in 1988. Having such ceremony here is in contradiction with all the values that the Canadian people, and including the Canadian government, has upheld for so many years. So the people here are, of course, very angry. These are mostly the victims of Khomeini's brutal era. Many have been political prisoners. Many have been victims of this regime. And that's why they are protesting in large number against this commemoration.
Shahram, this is not the first time that Khomeini has been honored in Canada. Why this particular event is important, actually, first of all, to be exposed, but also why is it important to oppose it and why are Iranians are angry about this?
Well, the reason for their anger is quite obvious because they feel that this is, as I mentioned, a contradiction. You can hear probably in the background the noise of the demonstration and the people who are protesting, the people who want to go and to commemorate him, as he was not only ordered the issue or fatwa against Iranian political prisoners, he issued the fatwa against non-Iranians. If you remember, he issued a fatwa against Salman Rushdie. He issued a fatwa against many other people. He issued a fatwa against Saudis. Mm. He said collaborating with them is just war against God. So that's why it has angered so many people. He has called for the annihilation of another state. Mm. And so the reason for their anger is quite obvious. The reason that, as you mentioned, this is not the first time, but why is it so important this time? Mm. It's because now the whole world knows about the dangers of Islamic fundamentalism much better than 2 years ago when they first have the ceremony here. So I believe that has helped our cause, basically, because we wanted to warn the world about the dangers of Islamic fundamentalism in the past 30 years. Unfortunately, it was usually on a deaf ear. But now, as you mentioned in the opening of your remarks, many politicians from all political stripes are lining up to condemn this type of glorification of terror by commemorating Khomeini.
Sure. Some people may say that Canada is a free country and we tolerate each other. What about the freedom of speech?
Yes, of course, Canada is a free country, and we honor and we enjoy the freedom. That's why we want to implement such freedom of expression that we enjoy here in a country like Iran that people don't enjoy that. But we have to also remember crime against humanity has no border as freedom has no border. In other words, as you can appreciate, Canada has, not only Canada, many Western countries and even other countries, have officially banned anyone affiliated with the Nazi regime and Hitler. And even half a century later, they are still deporting people who were involved in war crimes during the era of Hitler and promoting Hitler and Nazism and fascism is a crime punishable by law. Same would apply, and this is our argument, that same should and would apply to Khomeini, because he was no less of a threat to the world and he did no less harm to the world. That's why we are so much against this basically commemoration, and we are asking the Canadian government to use the applicable laws, and if they are not adequate, to enhance the applicable laws to be able to ban these events in the future.
Shahram, I didn't see one Iranian among the guest speaker for this event. What is the reason for that, and also do you think such an event is harmful to Canada?
Yes. Now, Iranian regime has become clever over time as well. So they usually don't use their Iranian agents, especially abroad. They want to have their outreach to non-Iranians, especially from citizens of countries in the region. If you recall, even the murders of the Kurdish dissidents in Germany that happened a couple of decades ago, they used people from Hezbollah and Lebanon and others to carry out those attacks in order to whitewash their footprint on these things. And this is exactly the same here. Of course, no Iranian not only dares, they hate this regime, and their Iranian agents are not welcome in Canada, but they use the people who have already been on their payroll for publicity purposes, and to also portray that this is a global movement.
Shahram, do you think this is an effort or a plan? Because we're getting close to the federal election in Canada, does it have anything to do with that election, or they want to pave the way to, for example, open the Iranian embassy in Ottawa? Do you know what their goal is?
I can speculate, but I really don't think that's the case. I believe more than anything else, it shows the weakness of the regime, especially when it is in impasse over the nuclear talks, when it is impasse on the economic side, that now even the officials of the same regime are now not only blaming each other, they blame the founders of this regime, including Khomeini, that while we were not involved in the war against the Iran-Iraq war or other things. So everyone tries to whitewash their hands and say that it was not us. But on the other hand, it shows the weaknesses of the regime in many fronts. By doing a ceremony like this, they want to uphold the spirit of what I call either the defectors or the poor people in their ranks, like the Basijis or people from the Revolutionary Guards, to say, well, you are active, you are present everywhere, including in Canada, that you don't have any diplomatic relationship. Mm-hmm. That's basically for domestic use. Otherwise, if you can see here, not a single person that even has gone. First of all, there were very few, actually, who appear to be attending this ceremony. Mm-hmm. Not a single person appear to be Iranian. They are mostly from other countries, mostly, again, from Pakistan and others. So, again, it has no effect on the Iranian side. It actually has added to the solidarity of the people against or around the common cause.
Shahram, I was especially disturbed by this event because I saw in their poster, I noticed that there are activities for children and young teenagers. I didn't see a mention of this event on their website either. Do you think this is a tool to brainwash kids in Canada?
Well, that could also be the case. Part of this event, as you said, that you were disturbed, obviously. I mean, nowadays that everyone is fighting against the ISIS or Daesh in the world, and they have seen some brutality of that school of thought, basically Islamic fundamentalism. Now, one of the issues that Canada is fighting against or fighting for is the issue of luring young people and children, basically, to that, and why brainwash them to this fundamentalism idea. And now this is one of the, I guess, prime examples of doing so, because they are offering, at least on the advertisement, they are offering to provide prizes for the children, for the kids to write essays for Khomeini. And to do these type of things, it's basically a glorification of Khomeini and fundamentalism and the terrorism.
Thank you, Shahram, for your time, and good luck with the protest today.
Thank you. Thank you for having me on the show.
Strength to face the giants. Come and join us, sound the sirens. For the king who saved the world, hear the voices in the